Mr. Speaker, I rise today to ask a simple question. When will this administration recognize the crisis at our southern border? Late last night, Customs and Border Protection released their record-shattering border crisis numbers once again. In the month of October, more than 164,000 illegal immigrants were apprehended. This is the worst October in DHS history. And these are only the numbers of those who were apprehended, not to mention the gotaways. Drug trafficking, human trafficking is surging. It is confirmed that MS-13 gang members are crossing into the United States, and hundreds of thousands, in fact, over 2.1 million, have entered this country illegally, with more advancing towards our southern border right now. Meanwhile, the administration is considering nearly $500,000 in payments to illegal immigrants who broke the law while they're not paying contractors to build the wall, and they're leaving already paid materials in the field to rot. All this is made worse by the fact that the president is forcing our brave Border Patrol officers, who are woefully understaffed and lacking the resources they need, to choose between their livelihoods and a vaccine mandate. We have seen reporting by the Border Patrol that nearly half of its agents could be fired in less than a week due to the administration's November 22nd COVID-19 vaccine deadline. It has never been more clear. The president has abandoned Texas and every other border state, and he is cutting his own Border Patrol agents off at the knees. It is long past time to admit that there is a crisis at our southern border, and that the men and women of the United States Border Patrol are overwhelmed, and they need their commander-in-chief to support them. This crisis is not slowing down. Mr. President, we urge you to secure the border, to not abandon Texas, and to come to our rescue. With that, I yield back.